Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Simon Banza. Today I wanted to make a video talking about being 25 years old. I'm 26 now, but what I wanted to talk to you guys about is things that I stopped believing at 25 years old. 25 was a rough year for me. 2020 was utter hell. I learned that rock bottom has a basement with no doors, no windows, just darkness and a lot of home music just playing. 2020 is the year that I learned that you can actually have a quarter life crisis. But you know what? I'm on the tail end of that now. That's ending. That's going away. I want to talk to you guys about some of the things that I stopped believing when I turned 25 years old. Well, in the year when I was 25, because I still kind of believed these things when I was 25. Rigorous. Hey. Gang gang looking rigorous. My champagne but I'm rigorous. My campaign looking rigorous. Whole team hella rigorous. Lifestyle so rigorous. Hairstyle so rigorous. Your top five ain't rigorous. If you left out this rigorous. So the first thing I want to talk about, I'm going to get right into it. I'm going to get controversial. Don't block me. Don't be mean to me. I'm just going to get right into it. You know the phrase multiple streams of income? No. Long story short, we shouldn't have to live like that. We shouldn't have to live in hustle culture. I'm not telling you anything new. People have been saying this for the past, I'm sure, 5-10 years, but I'm just here to remind you and to remind myself. Multiple streams of income is unnecessary. It should be unnecessary. You should be making enough money from your one job that you focused on, enough to live, enough to survive. The fact that a lot of us have to turn our hobbies into our careers because we need more money, and that's what it's about, is it not? What I think multiple streams of income meant, you know, maybe a couple of years ago, is that in your line of work, you try to make the most out of it so that you can make the most money. What I feel like it's become now is, even though you have this one job, even though you have this one thing you do, you have to think of 15 different other ways of making money that don't even have to do with this one thing. Before, it was just about diversifying the one thing that you do, but now, this isn't the movies. You shouldn't have to work 5 jobs in order to raise your kid. Like, no. Now, I want to say this very early. I know this is very idealistic. I know we do not live in a perfect world, and it sounds like I'm saying that we're very close to that. We're not. If anything, what I'm saying is this phrase should not be something that's glorified. If you found something that you really love, if you found something that you'd really love to turn into a career, you should be allowed to focus all your efforts just into that one thing. You should be allowed to survive off of that one thing. You look at South African celebrities, I think it's the one place where we always make fun of it. Like, South African celebrities will be actors, TV presenters, there will be DJs, you know, you'll be a YouTuber, a radio host, TV host. I don't like this game anymore. I just think if you want to dabble in a lot of things, it's because you should want to. I don't think it's because you should have to. And I think a lot of people in our generation feel like they should have to. As soon as you learn a new skill, as soon as you learn something that you really, really love, what's the first thought you have in your brain? How can I make money off of this? Every 2 seconds, you're just thinking about how you can make money off the little bit of fun that you have. I think to a certain degree that can be fun, making money out of the fun things in your life, but it's become such a focal point for people my age. And let me tell you guys, me, firm believer, firm believer, you can go search Sibum Banza multiple streams of income, and I promise you, you'll get like 3 to 5 tweets. And you know what? I'm saying this as one of those people who has it. I wish I didn't have to. I'm definitely talking from a point of privilege, not just with this, but with the other points that I'm gonna bring across. I shouldn't have to have multiple income streams in order to afford the things I need and some of the things I want. I don't think any of us should have to. Moving on, let's keep it in the realm of capitalism. I wanna talk to you guys about something that I think we've talked about before, and that's rest. And I just cannot emphasize enough how important it is. Rest is so important to your well-being. We are not machines, and I detest the notion that we could even be machines. Like, I'm not talking about robots, relax. I'm talking about people who are constantly working all the time, who are always having to be on. That's how we get burnt out. That's how we end up disliking our jobs, because we've overworked ourselves instead of finding good ways to put rest within our habits. And that is a major problem for me, and it's one of the things that I'm working most towards this year. Apart from self-confidence, my other thing that I'm learning is rest. And in 10 intentional rest. If you do not rest, your body will force you at some point. I don't care if it takes 2 months or it takes 2 years or it takes 20 years. Your body will come back and bite you in its own ass. Quick story. So in my high school, which I think is like most other high schools, they choose the prefects when they're in grade 11 in their final term. I remember I wasn't chosen as prefect, and I asked one of my... Sorry, it still hurts. I asked one of my friends who had recently become a prefect what it feels like. We're sitting at break, and even in that moment, I could see that something was up. And he said something to me. I'm talking about this like it's profound. It wasn't necessarily profound, but it just stuck with me. He said with all this responsibility that he's gotten, he, one, doesn't know when to rest and enjoy himself during, you know, break time. First break, second break, he's still worrying about what work he's supposed to be doing, and he feels like he should be doing something. Isn't that kind of like what adulthood is like? You're just trying to figure out what your best looks like. You're trying to figure out what working hard enough feels like. I used to feel bad about the privileges my job afforded me instead of just being grateful. And if there's one thing my job affords me, guys, if there's one thing I'm so grateful that I started this damn YouTube channel about, it's the fact that I can rest. I can rest. My time is my time. And honestly, the only thing more important to me in this world other than my PlayStation is my time. Obviously my family, my partner, my all those things, but like my PlayStation and my time, so that I have time to play on my PlayStation. I feel like just because that's the way things are, just because we live in a world where we're constantly told we have to be working, the more work you're doing, the more you're being a good member of society, the more chances you have of making money. Man, just rest, dog. And I know this is one of those things where it's like, yeah, but it depends what kind of job you have. I understand. Just find ways to rest. Shop, if you need to work till late in the evening during the week, I get it, you have that kind of job. But on the weekend, don't answer the phone. It's your time. Relax. I need rest to function. And if there's one thing I know, thanks to the internet, is that a lot of people are just like me, which means you watching this video right now need rest to function too. So find it, find those pockets of rest and intentionally do it. I dare you. Okay, before I go, I want to talk about the last one. Now, we all know this one, especially if you're a black kid, you've heard it over and over again. One of the things I stopped believing when I turned 25 is that you need to care what people think. I fully grew up thinking you need to care what people think. And listen to why. I figured that if I cared what people think, I would not make silly societal mistakes. If I constantly cared, constantly thought if people are judging me, I will not make mistakes. Turns out, I will still make mistakes. The fear of being judged is such a massive inhibitor of success. Whatever success looks like for you, let me not even say success. Success is far away. Starting. It's an inhibitor of starting. Starting that thing you want to do. Carrying on with that thing you want to do. If there's one thing that has stopped me from just living my damn life, it's worrying what other people are gonna think. And if there's one thing that I've noticed when it comes to my line of work, the people who do the best are the people who do not care a damn what other people think. The people who just do it for themselves. Now, there is a very thin line. When you don't care what people think, sometimes you can, one, infringe on people's rights, hurt people physically or emotionally. Don't do that. You know what we mean. You know what we're talking about. Some things are definitely supposed to be judged. That's why we have judges. Basically, what I'm saying is I understand that it's a double-edged sword, but do not let abantu bazothini control you. Don't be scared to start over. Don't be scared to be bad at things. Don't worry about what people are going to think of you. Most of the time, people don't care. Do you know what's the most debilitating? Yes. Do you know what the most debilitating thing is about abantu bazothini syndrome? It's the fact that when you don't do the thing, sharp, nobody says anything about you. Nobody judges you. Nobody says your work is whack. Nobody says, wow, that's so awkward. I can't believe you had to move home because you went broke. Nobody says that. Sharp, you're not judged. But then you also didn't do the thing and you're still standing exactly where you were a week ago, months ago. Sharp, nobody's saying anything. Nobody's talking about you. Nobody's judging you. But what have you done? But if you do the thing, sure, maybe one or two people talk about you. Maybe it's not something you want to hear. It don't matter. Just do it. You'll thank yourself in the future. People will talk. Most people won't. Think about yourself. What's best for you? I hope you guys know that I'm actually talking to myself here. I'm not necessarily talking to you. I'm fully talking to myself because, wow, I do not listen. I'm going to end it off there. I don't want this to be too long. I'm sure already I'm just looking at my camera and I've been talking for 20 minutes. But man, I just wanted to come here and tell you guys that having a quarter life crisis is normal. Having a life crisis at 18 is normal. Having a life crisis at 30 is normal. Rock bottom has a basement, but damn, you can get out of it. I am so excited for what the rest of this year has to bring. I am not as anxious as I was before. I'm just taking things one week at a time. I'm learning a lot, but clearly I'm also unlearning. I'm not believing a lot of things I used to believe before, and I think that's a good thing. I think you should be allowed to stop believing certain things. I should be allowed to do the same. It's the only way that we're going to become better people for ourselves and for everybody around us. Thank you very much for watching. Let me know what is something you've recently stopped believing, something you really thought, you know what, this is the word. This is the word. And now you're like, It's fine. It's a safe space. I'll see you guys soon with another video. Gang gang looking rigorous. My champagne, but I'm rigorous. My campaign looking rigorous. Whole team hella rigorous. Lifestyle so rigorous. Hairstyle so rigorous. The top five ain't rigorous. If you left out this rigorous.